There was it was a partnership between U of M, MTC, and MDOT mm-hmm. on the design. You know, what did we need to have here? Mm-hmm. And there was some, you know, outreach to the industry about, you know, for in a test facility like this, what would it need to include to be useful? Mm-hmm. Yeah, the details are really kind of incredible, mm-hmm. the thought that was put into it. Because really, you are trying to recreate any scenario that you would find in, again, what I described as that complex urban environment. Mm-hmm. And here's the stop sign I mentioned, which came out of real off a rural road that was in service in Michigan, I think, up until last summer. So imagine it being nighttime and you can't see that it says stop if you're a driverless car. Yeah. We're approaching now. You see the poles. This is a tree canopy, and it is designed to simulate various levels of foliage. And this is kind of entering our urban downtown. Again, you'll see all the signalized intersections. We have the street lights. It's the lane markings are set up now, as you would see in many urban situations, with turn only lanes and turn lanes that also have straight, you can go straight. So here we have an example of an exit ramp, and that's really one of the main purposes of this straightaway, was for vehicles to negotiate on and off ramps. An example here of the defaced yield sign and another black wake. We believe that the greatest potential for safety, energy use, and really improvements in mobility lie in connectivity plus automation, with a fully automated vehicle being a driverless car.